having a Bahá'í ceremony planned for you this morning. The Bahá'í marriage, the laws in our holy book, which is the Kitab al-Aqdas, the most holy book. Marriage is highly recommended, but not obligatory. Plurality of wives is forbidden. Marriage is conditioned upon both parties having attained the age of maturity, which is fixed at 15. Marriage is conditioned on the consent of both parties and their parents, whether the woman be a maiden or not. It is incumbent upon both parties to recite a specifically revealed verse indicating that being content with the will of God. So we will begin.
Bahá'í marriage is a union and cordial affection between two parties. They must, however, exercise the utmost care and become acquainted with each other's character. This eternal bond should be made secure by a firm covenant, and the intention should be to foster harmony, fellowship, and union, and to attain everlasting life. The pledge of marriage, the verse to be spoken individually by the bride and the bridegroom, in the presence of at least two witnesses, acceptable to the spiritual assembly, is stipulated in the Kitab al-Aqdas, the most holy book. We will all verily abide by the will of God. We will all verily abide by the will of God.
We will all verily abide by the will of God.
He is the bestower, the bounteous. Praise be to God, the ancient, the ever-abiding, the changeless, the eternal. He who hath testified in his own being that verily he is the one, the single, the untrammeled, the exalted. We bear witness that verily there is no God but him, acknowledging his oneness, confessing his singleness, he hath ever dwelt in unapproachable heights, in the summits of his loftiness, sanctified from the mention of aught save himself, free from the description of aught but him. And when he desired to manifest grace and benefits it to men, and to set the world in order, he revealed observances and created laws. Among them, he established the law of marriage, made it as a fortress for the well-being and salvation, and enjoined it upon us in that which was sent down out of the heaven of sanctity in this most holy book. He saith, great is his glory. Marry, O people, that from you may appear he who will remember me amongst my servants. This is one of my commandments unto you. Obey it as an assistance to yourself.
It says on the certificate of Bahá'í marriage, when he desired to manifest grace and beneficence to men and to set the world in order, he revealed observances and created laws. Among them, he established the law of marriage, made it a fortress for well-being and salvation, and enjoined it upon us in that which was sent down out of the heaven of sanctity in his most holy book, Bahá'u'lláh. And we are going to have the signature of the bride. If you wanted to say the verse again, you're more than welcome to say it.
We will all verily abide by the will of God.
Right on the table if you wish.
so much.
And I'm sorry, I don't want to cross in front of you.
Thank you. We will all verily abide by the will of God. You want to say it? I'll say it. I need you to say it in the
Inna kullan lillahi
radiyun. Inna kullan lillahi radiyun.
What was that in English?
When he said, we all verily abide by the will of God.
Oh.
It was said in Arabic.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Congratulations.
Now, please. This is your problem. Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. I'm so nervous.
You're doing fine, son.
Please. See, she thinks ahead.
All right, so.
Okay. Fat knuckles.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, guys.
Congratulations. Right. You have more Baha'i prayer selections for you, and then we're going to have it.
I hope. Together, you're living together long time, same as me and my husband. 63 years we are married. And your father and mother, 25 years married. I hope you're 100.
All right. Good job, Grandma.
No, we're going to do a couple of other prayers.
Okay.
And
okay.
Glory be unto thee, O my God. Verily, this thy servant and this thy maidservant have gathered under the shadow of thy mercy, and they're united through thy favor and generosity. O Lord, assist them in this thy world and thy kingdom, and destine for them every good through thy bounty and grace. O Lord, confirm them in thy servitude and assist them in thy service. Suffer them to become the signs of thy name in thy world, and protect them through thy bestowals, which are inexhaustible in this world and the world to come. O Lord, they are supplicating the kingdom of thy mercifulness and invoking the realm of thy singleness. Verily, they are married in obedience to thy command. Cause them to become the signs of harmony and unity until the end of time. Verily, thou art the omnipotent, the omnipresent, and the almighty. Abdu'l-Bahá.
He is God. O peerless Lord, in thine almighty wisdom, thou hast enjoined marriage upon the peoples, that the generations of men may succeed one another in this contingent world, and that ever so long as the world shall last, they may busy themselves at the threshold of thy oneness, with servitude and worship, with salutation, adoration, and praise. I have not created spirits and men, but that they should worship me. Wherefore, wed thou in heaven of thy mercy these two birds of the nest of thy love, and make them the means of attracting perpetual grace, that from the union of these two seas of love, a wave of tenderness may surge, and cast the pearls of pure and goodly issue on the shore of life. He hath let loose the two seas, that they meet each other. Between them is a barrier which they overpass not, which then of the bounties of your Lord will you deny, from which he bringeth up the greater and lesser pearls. O thou kind Lord, make thou this marriage to bring forth coral and pearls. Thou art verily the all-powerful, the most great, the ever-forgiving. O my Lord, O my Lord. These two bright moons are wedded in thy love, conjoined in servitude to thy holy threshold, united in ministering to thy cause. Make thou this marriage to be as a threading life of thine abounding grace. O my Lord, the all-merciful, the luminous rays of thy bestowals, O thou the beneficent, the ever-giving, that there may branch out from this great tree boughs that will grow green and flourishing through the gifts that rain down from thy clouds of grace. Verily, thou art the generous, verily, thou art the compassionate, the all-merciful.
We wanted to say something for everyone to hear. Thank you for everyone who has come on such short notice, as spontaneous as it was. This is, as we felt it should be, something simple, something down to earth, something that allows us to share our moment together with all who in such short notice could put whatever they were doing aside and be here. We thank you. And even those who are here over a video, we thank you. And we were talking with each other. What is our purpose? Why are we getting married? But most importantly, what do we plan to do with our lives together? As soon as Amira, if you want to say anything, please, you're more than welcome, please. But she wants me to talk, so I'm, you know, it's like hands side behind my back. I like doing half-half, you know, but this time, I guess, okay. What we plan on doing, our purpose is none other than a service to the entire human race. Our service is none other than to our communities surrounding us, and in whatever way we do our service within our communities, thinking with global aspirations, thinking with something that will extend far beyond our lives. So thinking with intentions and aspirations that will bring people with similar motives, with similar desires, with similar wishes to fulfill in their life, to make the most of their life for the lives of others. We plan to invest our time and our energy, not only in service to our own family, to have our own family, to grow our own family. We plan on being able to spend all our time, not just merely in service to others, but in improving the quality of life that we have and that everyone else has. And these aspirations we have are not limited. They are not something that we are merely planning now. Just as we were flexible, we are flexible, and we will be flexible. Change is life. Without life, without change, the other does not exist in this world. And we know that over time we will change. We know over time, not merely will we grow old, but our personalities will change. What we liked yesterday, we liked the color red. I don't plan on ever giving up my desire for the color red. I like red. But say I become older and I start liking blue. I like blue now, it's changed, right? That's me though, I change. So too Lamira. And irrespective of that change, our common purpose, our common love for our Creator and our desire to serve Him will keep us together to the end of our lives. And that's all I can say.
Good.
I love you.
Love you. All right. Well.
And also we're going to have beautiful songs played. It's by a Persian instrument, santur.
No, we're together.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Please. John, look in the mirror. Amira, please. I want to make this nice one. Good.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, for coming.
Yeah, but we are going to have the Santour selection, so please enjoy it.
Please enjoy the selection.
Thank you.
Johnny White. He's one of the most selfless men in the community here. Right here. Take a picture?
Hooray!
I'm videoing you.
Oh, you're videoing!
All right.
Thank you so much. It's so beautiful. That was my grandfather, everybody.
How you doing?
Rohola Eskandari.
Yes.
Simin Dov Eskandari. My grandmother. This is Amira's family from Bahrain. Only Bahrain? Right here. Take a look. You see? It's Amira's family. That's her mother. That's her mother, father. That's her sister right there. And then that's her aunt right there. All of them together. And her brother too. Her brother's there. Here, Amira. So everyone. Thank you for watching our video. We love you, and we hope that you have a wonderful life as well. And that you too, if you're not married, you find someone that you love, you share a purpose with, and you marry each other.
Okay, John.
All right, bye. Oh, here. Come on, kiss me.
Oh, I'm just
all right.